Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, I'm going to tell you how to enable OTA-based firmware upgrading feature to the ESP32 module, and we'll also walk through how to add this OTA-based feature to the existing ESP32-based projects, and what are the precautionary measures you have to take while adding this feature to the existing projects. So let's see how we can do this. This project is sponsored by PCBWay.com. PCBWay.com is one-stop solution for all your PCB needs like PCB prototyping, assembly stencil, assembly and all. Currently, they are offering 10 pieces of 2-layer PCBs at just $5. So get your PCBs ready at PCBWay.com. The link is in the description below. Now let's dive into the episode. What is OTA programming in ESP32? A fantastic feature of any Wi-Fi-enabled microcontroller is the ability to update its firmware wirelessly. This is known as the over-the-air or OTA firmware update. The ESP32 OTA programming allows updating or uploading new program to ESP32 using Wi-Fi instead of physical connection of ESP32 with a computer via USB. OTA functionality is extremely useful in case of no physical access to the ESP32 module. It helps us to reduce the amount of the time spent on the updating each ESP module at the time of maintenance. One important feature of OTA is that one central location can send an update to multiple ESPs sharing the same network. There are so many ways to enable OTA firmware updating feature to the ESP32 module, but I felt this AsyncElegantOTA Arduino library is the simplest way. I will explain you why this is the simplest way in the next few minutes. We will use the AsyncElegantOTA Arduino library to enable the OTA firmware updating feature to the ESP32 module. First of all, I would like to appreciate and thank Ayush Sharma, the author of this library, for his brilliant work. AsyncElegantOTA provides a beautiful interface to upload over-the-air updates to the ESP modules with precise status and progress displayed over UI. This version of the library uses Async web server. We have to use .bin files of the firmware while uploading to the ESP32. How to install AsyncElegantOTA Arduino library? Go to Sketch, Include Library, Library Manager, search for AsyncElegantOTA and install it. As the library uses Async web server library, we have to install the following libraries: AsyncTCP.h and ESPAsyncWebServer.h. Make sure you have installed these two libraries. Once the installation of the library is completed, open ESP32_async_demo_sketch from the Arduino examples /AsyncElegantOTA. This is just an async web server demo sketch with three AsyncElegantOTA library lines added. Let's see what are these three. Included AsyncElegantOTA library at the top of the code. Added this line above the server.begin statement. Finally, added this line in while loop. That's it. You have to add these three lines to any existing ESP32 based async web server projects to enable the OTA firmware update. Very simple, right? That's why I stated above as this may be the simplest way to upgrade your ESP32 projects to OTA firmware update. Let's test this feature. On the first go, we have to upload this code to the ESP32 manually, which is the regular process. So connect the ESP32 with laptop, check uploading configurations and upload it. After successful uploading, open serial monitor. Now copy the IP address displayed over the serial monitor and go to the IP address in the web browser. If the web server working fine, you will see this message on the web page. Now go to the IP address /update in the browser. A beautiful interface to upload over-the-air updates to ESP modules will appear. Here you can select either firmware or file system option based on the requirement. This library will help us to transfer the files like X509 certificates or HTML web pages to the ESP32 file system using this option. We can also upgrade the firmware of ESP32 using this firmware option. I would like to upload this blink sketch to the ESP32 with OTA. As I have already explained, we have to use .bin files while sending firmware to the ESP32. So first convert your code to binary file. In Arduino, we can do it very easily with this option. After converting, the binary file will be saved along with the main code. Select this code from the web page. It will automatically upload to the ESP32. After successful uploading, you can see the ESP32 blinking as per the updated firmware. That's it, we have successfully made it. If you want to update another firmware, the OTA feature is not working. The main webpage is also not working. Did you find something why this is happening? Yes, you are right. We haven't added AsyncElegantOTA feature and async web server on the newly updated code. That's why we are not able to communicate with ESP32 over the air now. So let's add these and try again. Merged blink sketch and AsyncElegantOTA sketch. A binary file created. Selected binary file from the OTA webpage and successfully uploaded to the ESP32. Now the ESP32 blinking as per the new firmware as well as the OTA feature is also working very fine. Also, we can update the new firmware again and again. This is the one of the most important things you have to consider while enabling the OTA feature to the ESP32 module. Otherwise, we cannot communicate with the ESP32 from next time onwards. So that's all about ESP32 OTA or over-the-air firmware updates using the AsyncElegantOTA library. I hope you have learned something new from this episode. Stay tuned to electronicsinnovation.com for more interesting projects and exciting features to your existing projects. See you on the next interesting episode. Bye-bye.